It's UC Lamps here. You're welcome to today's episode. In my previous video, I explained and discussed the term rooting. Today, I'll be detailing the steps on how to root your Android smartphone easily. Do note that this video is a compilation of steps that has worked for many Android smartphones. It is not universally applicable. What I mean by this is that these steps may or may not work for your Android smartphone. If this is your first time here in my channel, make sure you click the subscribe button to subscribe to my channel and also turn on the post notification to get weekly updates of my videos. Straight into the video. In my previous video, I explained some terms which you might come across in the process of rooting. You can see the link to that video up here. We'll be using more of those terms in this video and we'll be seeing them functioning. Before you root your Android phone, you would need some things. Some of these things include a Windows PC running at least a Windows 7. You would also need a good USB cable to communicate between your PC and your Android device. You would need a custom recovery. You would also need the Magisk zip file. I'll leave the link to that in the description below. You would need ADB and Fastboot. I'll leave the link to that in the description too. You would need drivers for your device. I will also leave the link to the drivers for Fastboot in the description. And obviously, you would need an Android smartphone because that is what you're going to be rooting. I have organized this video into steps and we'll be going step by step to root your Android device easily. I repeat again, these steps are steps I have compiled that has worked for many Android phones. So these steps may or may not work for your device and it won't be entirely similar. And that is why I want you to engage me in the comment section. Whatever help you need, I will get you through it. Just leave a comment with what you are facing and I will get you through it. Let's get into the steps of owning your device. As you know, rooting is owning your device. If you've not seen my previous video, you may not understand what I'm talking about. You can check out the link to my previous video here to know more about owning your device. Step 1. Getting your custom recovery. A simple Google search would get you your custom recovery. For instance, you can search custom recovery for the OnePlus 6 and there would be various searches which will give you the link to your custom recovery. Another way is going to the twrp.me. Once you go to twrp.me, you head over to the devices page, you search your device, in my case OnePlus. And then you search the variant of your own device, OnePlus 6 in my case. You follow the links and download the custom recovery for your phone. There are many other custom recoveries for your phone. TWRP is the most commonly used. One thing you should know is that the recovery you are downloading should be meant for your device and only your device. Do not download the recovery for the OnePlus 6T for the OnePlus 6. As they are not compatible. So make sure the recovery you are downloading is meant for your own device. You can find your device name in case you don't know how to check your device name. You can find that in your settings about phone. You check there, you see your device name and then you can use that to Google search or go to twrp.me. Once you've downloaded the custom recovery, we can proceed to step 2. Step 2. Unlocking your bootloader. Before you go ahead to step 2, make sure you've backed up your device and move it to your PC, as unlocking your bootloader would format your device. To unlock your bootloader, you need to allow USB debugging and also allow OEM unlock. You can do this in the developer options in your device. You can access your developer options by going to your settings, about phone, click on build number until it says you are now a developer. Then you can access the developer options. Go into the developer options and allow USB debugging and also allow OEM unlocking. Allowing OEM unlocking allows your bootloader to be unlocked. And allowing USB debugging allows your device to communicate with your PC through ADB. Now you can't communicate with your PC without setting up ADB on your PC. You can set up ADB on your PC with the following steps. Once you have everything set up, you open the command prompt on your PC and type ADB devices with your phone connected via USB cable to your PC. And then there should be a prompt on your device requesting you allow your PC communicate with your device. You have to allow this prompt to enable your PC communicate with your device. Once you've done this, it should show that your device has been connected. Then you type the command ADB reboot bootloader, and then your device would reboot into the bootloader. Once you are in bootloader mode, you run the command fastboot OEM unlock. Now this code would unlock your bootloader. In some cases, it may require an unlock code. All you have to do is simply Google how to get unlock code for your device manufacturer name in case of Motorola, how to get unlock code for Motorola, and follow the steps. Then you will get your unlock code in easy steps. Once you have your unlock code, you run the same command fastboot OEM unlock, then you put your unlock code and your device would reboot and your phone will be formatted. Hence, your device bootloader would be unlocked. Once we are done with this, we proceed to step 3, which is the final step. Step 3, flashing your custom recovery and installing the magisk zip file. Make sure you've moved your custom recovery to your PC, and if it is in a zip file, extract it. Move the magisk zip file you downloaded from the description below to your phone. Now, reboot your phone into bootloader mode with the same steps we used from earlier on. Now that your phone is in bootloader mode, run the command fastboot flash recovery, then attach the location of the recovery file you extracted to it. You can do this by simply dragging the recovery file from your desktop or wherever it is straight into the command prompt. Once this command is done, you have flashed the custom recovery successfully. Now, this step may vary for devices having A and B slots, like the OnePlus 6. If your phone is like this, leave a comment and I'll tell you how to go about doing it easily. Still in bootloader mode, press the power button plus the volume plus button simultaneously to reboot straight into recovery. Do not reboot your device into the system, as your device will replace the custom recovery you just flashed. So you have to make sure you reboot directly into the custom recovery so as to retain that custom recovery. Once you are in the custom recovery, you press install, navigate to where you have your magisk zip file, choose it and swipe to install. Voila, your device is rooted. All you have to do is reboot your phone into the system. If you had any problem along any of the steps, do let me know in the comment section and I'll be sure to guide you on how to fix it. It's Yusilams here once again. Don't forget to follow me on other social media. See you in my next video.